What's up, guys? It's Jordy here for CineCam.net, and welcome to Copycat Friday! Now, this is a creative series where we find a way to recreate a certain effect from a music video, a film, or any other video creator. And today we are taking a look at the K-pop girls band Twice, and we're going to recreate several transitions effects from it. So let's swing into it! Today's video is sponsored by Videoblocks, an amazing library where you can download stock clips, video effects, templates, animations, and so much more. And we've actually been using it for more than a year now and can honestly recommend it to any video creator. Definitely make sure to check it out. You can do so by clicking the first link in the description below. So like I already mentioned, we're looking today at a girls band called Twice. And what I always love about the K-pop music videos is their camera style. It's always so dynamic, and we actually did a video about BTS a while back where we recreated 5 complex camera movements with some basic tools and a little bit of editing. Now this time we're going to recreate 5 transitions from Twice, the music videos, and we're going to focus on simplicity. But that doesn't mean that we can't create some fun set designs in our studio.
Blue backlights.
You tried to hide your behavior, but now I've discovered your lies.
The first one is going to be the turbulent displacement transition. And you want to take one shot from your actor, another shot from a different actor or setup, and one empty shot of the scene. Important is that you shoot everything from a tripod.
So when filming, you don't touch camera because your second shot has to be the same position and don't want a jumper.
And now we change clothes, but I'm going to make sure that I keep standing on the same spot. That way we can cut to the exact same position right here, and that way the transition is going to look very nice. Throw me the hat, Janik. Woo! Throw me the shirt, Janik. Woo! Editing magic. In Adobe Premiere Pro, you then place your acting or dancing clips next to each other and insert a piece of the empty shot underneath the cut of that. Then select your first clip and head over to the opacity property. You want to animate that value so that the clip fades out to around 40%, but make sure that the animation only takes a couple of frames. Then do the exact same thing with the second clip, only here you want to start from 40% and go back to 100%. And because we have that empty shot on the bottom, the characters will actually now look like a ghost instead of having the entire clip fading to black. Then drag an adjustment layer over the cut and add the turbulent displace effect to it. And you may already set the displacement to turbulent smoother. Then where you'd like the transition to start, you create a keyframe for the amount, size, and evolution. In the beginning, you don't want to see your shot to go weird, so we'll just change the value of the amount to 0, the size may be around 20, and the evolution goes to minus 15. Then go to where you have the cut between your two clips and change the amount to 10, the size to 200, and the evolution to 0. Then go again a little bit further in time, and now you want to go back to the same values as you had in the beginning. And you know, you can easily do that by selecting your first keyframes, copying them, and pasting them on the ending position. The next transition is the camcorder transition, like you're seeing right here. And this one is actually a little bit more complex, that would require Adobe After Effects and some motion tracking to do the job, so that's why we came up with this simple solution. Your shots are nothing special, just film 2 scenes of whatever you like. So we're trying to make our shot underneath this bridge right here, but there are just so many cars! Go, 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 go! Then the camcorder is going to be a still photo, and you can actually get it from a stock library, but if you can, I would suggest you make your own still image. And the reason for that is because you need to match the lighting of your first scene with that still picture. So we looked at where the sun was coming from and placed a light in the studio in that same position as well. Then snap your picture and bring it into Photoshop. Then with the pen tool, we're cutting out the camcorder so that we're left with a transparent background. And if you want to keep it all in Premiere Pro, you can also mask it out in there as well. Your first shot goes on the bottom, on top of that the camcorder picture. And on top of that, your second shot, add a cut on the second layer where your clip on the bottom stops. Then select the first part and the camcorder, right-click and choose Nest. Double-click on the nest to open it up, and in here you want to scale down your normal shot so that it fits within the display. To make it blend even better, we're adding a mask around it, plus increasing the feather. Then going back to the main sequence, I'm adding a fake movement to the nested sequence. And I would recommend to do this with the transform effect. And finally, I'm adding a Gaussian blur to the nested sequence as well, to make it appear out of focus. And to make it even more natural, I will actually animate the Gaussian blur and make it increase slightly over time, because eventually you want to have the camera coming closer to the frame. And to do that, I'm adding an adjustment layer on top. Add the transform effect to it and animate the scale plus the position to make it zoom in. Also here, make sure to enable motion blur. The transition already works, but it's probably not so smooth. And that's why I'm first of all adding again that transform effect to the second clip, as I want to animate a small bump into the beginning with the scale property. Now, they actually didn't do it in their music video this way, but I believe that this one looks a little bit better apart from the camcorder motion. I picked you up on my radar, I know what you made of tonight. The next one is pretty fun. You want to film a couple of scenes and every time try to match the ending position of your characters with the beginning position of your follow-up shot. And that way the transition will come out a little bit better. Just film your shots and that's it.
And we're going to first record a transition element. And for that I'm actually using this thing right here, which is a filter holder for one of our lights. And we're just going to wipe that in front of the green screen and then wipe back out. But if you don't have something like this, you can also use your hands. For example, make a heart shape, bring that into the green screen and then roll back out. Once you got that shot, you can basically use that anywhere where you want.
If you don't have a green screen, just print out some green papers or look for a green t-shirt.
So now Jordi is in his end move. So we're gonna tape it where we stand so we can match the next shot with it.
And I have to stand really, really still.
Then in Premiere Pro, I'm using the Ultra key to remove the green. And that will reveal the two shots I have underneath. If you can cover up the cut with the edge of the object when it covers the entire lens, you already have yourself a nice transition. But to make it appear more like a lens kind of thing, I'm adding the lens distortion effect to the second clip. And the only thing that you have to do now is animate the curvature from -5 back to 0. That brings us to the fourth transition, which is the tree wipe. Film your subject going in one direction, running, skating, whatever. Make sure that there's something that passes between your subject and the camera, like a tree. Then film a second shot of again someone going to that same direction, and to make the transition go smooth, we're paying attention to the speed of the following camera. We're shooting outside of a car, so we could look at the speed indicator.
So after the skateboard shot, we transition to Lorenzo right here, skating. But he broke his skates!
Feels bad, man.
So Janik just came up with an ingenious idea. But to find out what that is, make sure to follow us on Instagram and see what we posted over there and see what Janik came up with. It's pretty ingenious. Now let's try out if his invention works. Yeah, so that didn't work well. Sorry, Janik, but your invention does not work. Okay, Lorenzo, I think you're going to have to run with the skates in your hands.
Going again in Premiere, put the shot with the tree on top of the other one. Select the upper clip and head over to the opacity property. Click on the pen tool to draw a mask next to the tree. Then enable the animation, move one frame forward, adjust your mask and continue. And this brings us to the last transition, which is pretty similar, but like you can see over here, we can actually add some extra effects to it to make it look more realistic. Film your subject and some vehicle that passes your shot. And of course, then just take your second shot. Now for a more smoother transition, try to keep the same focal length and camera height. In Premiere Pro, you again mask out the back of the truck as it's passing by, and that will reveal your second shot underneath. But you know, to really make this transition work, we're going to add a few things to it. First of all, you can work with a smoke machine, then fill up your space and let someone run quickly through the smoke.
Zonder geluid.
That was Lorenzo, who is doing an internship at Cinecom, and he's doing a great job at being a truck. Good job, Lorenzo. So this way the smoke flows in a certain direction, making it seem like it came from the truck. and you can also add some post-production smoke to it. Here's a clip I got from Videoblox, which I can simply blend on top of my shot using the screen blend mode. You might need to mask out a part of that smoke and speed it up to get it into the movement that you need. But you know, by adding these little elements to it, it makes the passing truck to be more part of your second clip. So what's up with these trucks these days? All that smoke? So guys, that was it again. 5 creative transitions from the music clips from Twice. And you know what else is Twice? Our upload scheme. So make sure to hit that subscribe button to see us twice a week. That's an amazing pun. And also, if you liked the video, make sure to hit the thumbs up button. Thank you again so much for watching. And like always, stay creative.
Catch!
He is going insane today.
Derek, catch! Derek, catch!
It has happened. He lost his mind. YouTube is too much for him.